As rising energy costs continue to grab headlines, Americans are paying more attention to alternatives to fossil fuels. Renewable energy sources such as solar, wind, and biomass power hold great promise, but communities struggle with where to build these facilities. Hello and welcome to Green Scene, EPA's environmental podcast series that you can take with you. I'm Judy Pino. EPA has recently developed a series of state maps that show thousands of contaminated properties across the country that have potential to host renewable energy facilities. And here to tell us more about this very interesting project is Penny McDaniel from EPA's Office of Solid Waste and Emergency Response. Penny, welcome.
Thank you.
Well, let's start with the basics, shall we? Let's explain to the audience just what is renewable energy.
Well, renewable energy comes from sources that are readily replenished. They are continually replenished, and we are familiar with some of those, such as wind and solar and some forms of biomass.
That's right. You mentioned solar, wind, and biomass. Well, let's talk about how these work.
Okay. The general concept is that we can take, using various technologies, we can take the energy that's stored in sun and in the wind and in various sources of biomass, and we can convert those into usable sources of energy like electricity and fuels.
And that works the same for wind and biomass?
Well, there are different technologies to harness that energy. So for solar, for example, you can use photovoltaic panels to take the sun and convert that into electricity. For wind, you can use wind turbines to capture the wind, if you will, the motion of the wind, and turn that into electricity as well. And biomass comes from sources of biological material, organic material, that can be harnessed in a variety of ways to produce electricity and fuels, alternative fuels.
Now, why is renewable energy important right now? We hear about it all the time, right?
Well, renewable energy is important right now because as traditional sources of energy are rising in cost, as we've seen a lot in the news these days, it makes other non-traditional sources of energy, such as renewable energy, solar, wind, biomass, more cost effective. In addition, we hear a lot in the news about energy independence and energy security.
Sure.
And these, development of renewable energy and adding that to our portfolio of energy in this country really lends itself to getting us to that point of energy independence and security.
And of course, the concern of greenhouse gas emissions.
Of course. So using renewable energy is a much cleaner way of providing energy to our homes and to our businesses. They have fewer greenhouse gases, and in a time of concern about the effects of climate change, it's ever more important to explore those options.
And we all know that renewable energy technologies are becoming more and more efficient.
They are. The technologies are improving all the time, and they're becoming more efficient and therefore more cost effective.
Now, your office has been looking at contaminated lands as sites for renewable energy. Well, what is the connection between contaminated lands and renewable energy?
Well, to site a renewable energy production facility, say, for example, a solar field or a wind farm, you need land. And many of these EPA tracked sites or contaminated lands offer a lot of the amenities, if you will, that are necessary for siting these types of energy production, renewable energy production facilities.
Now, Penny, let's define contaminated lands. If they're contaminated, are they safe?
So contaminated lands are lands that have been used in the past by industry and mining operations that have led to releases of hazardous substances into the environment that pose a risk to human health or the environment, and require that EPA get involved and clean them up.
Right.
So what we have done is, in many of these sites, we have cleaned them up and gotten them to a point for reuse, so that they are ready for reuse and redevelopment with facilities such as renewable energy production facilities.
And what makes these lands better than any other type of land mm-hmm. to be used for renewable energy?
Well, they're a great opportunity for developing renewable energies. As I mentioned a little bit earlier, they provide a lot of the infrastructure that is needed for siting renewable energy facilities, such as transmission lines and roads for access and railways for access. And many of these lands have been zoned properly for siting these types of facilities, so they're zoned for industrial and commercial use, so that you don't need to go through that process of rezoning. So,
not to mention a source of employment.
There are some of these sites have in the past provided jobs to the local communities, such as, you know, large industrial facilities and mining sites. But when those closed up and left, many of the jobs went with them. So we see this as an opportunity to provide, if you will, green-collar jobs for the operation and maintenance of the renewable energy facilities, as well as, you know, even manufacturing components for the wind turbines and the solar panels.
Okay, so let's talk about EPA's new resource for information specifically on this subject.
Okay, well, what we've done is we've worked with the National Renewable Energy Lab, and we have combined their data on renewable energy sources with our data on available lands for redevelopment. And we together have come up with criteria to screen out these sites. So we ended up with a nice, robust list of EPA tracked sites or contaminated lands that qualify, if you will, for renewable energy development.
In all 50 states, and you guys have a lot of cool stuff on this site, a virtual map, also fact sheets and everything else, information incentives, and Google Earth, so you can see the actual land space available.
That's right. We've developed maps, as you mentioned, for all states. So you can see, and anybody who's interested can see the renewable energy potential on EPA track sites in their state for wind, solar, and biomass. We've also developed incentive sheets that outline the financial incentives for developing renewable energy, as well as incentives for developing contaminated lands.
And of course, you can find that at epa.gov/renewable-energy-land. Who can use these tools?
Well, anybody who's interested in developing renewable energy, such as developers, renewable energy developers, communities, municipalities, states. Many states have renewable portfolio standards, and they are looking for ways of meeting those renewable portfolio standards that require a certain percentage of renewable energy production in their state.
And what a great way to revitalize impaired lands while putting them back to productive use. Well, thanks, Penny McDaniel with EPA's Office of Solid Waste and Emergency Response for being with us. And to learn more about renewable energy development potential on contaminated lands, please visit www.epa.gov/renewable-energy-land. See you next time on Green Scene.